Hey everyone, this is a preview of what we'll be working on today, Midjourney permutations. We're going to get super creative with this, so let's get going. Midjourney permutations are a way of writing one prompt and then spawning multiple prompts. So you're going to need fast hours to do this, and you can do up to 40 individual spawned prompts with just writing one prompt. To get started, I'll show you the basics, but you may want to take a look at their documentation. So Midjourney has great documentation, and we'll just type in permutations. So there we go. And it gives you the basics here, and I'll show you a few things to begin with, and then we'll really get into it and get creative. So essentially, it's putting these curly braces in. And so this would be three different prompts, all from one prompt. So this would spawn three different prompts here. A red, green, yellow, bird, and that spawns three prompts. May as well show you the template, because they give you a template, which is really helpful. So I could do curly braces, a dog, comma, cat. And then I'll just hit return, and it shows you that there will be two prompts. And because we have a dog and a cat in these curly braces separated by a comma, that's key. So in permutations, if you normally are in the habit of separating parts of a prompt with a comma, you can do that in a permutation with a backslash before the comma, and it shows you how to do that in the documentation. And I'll link to the documentation and the notes. So we can actually edit the template, and I could do, and you can do anything with a permutation. It doesn't have to just be the prompt. It can be the arguments at the end, anything with a dash dash. As you can see, I'm using Midjourney 6 here as my default, so I don't really need to type it in. I can just do this. So I'll go dash AR. Aspect ratio, and I'll do 3x2, comma, and how about 4x5? Whoops. Okay, so that would be, so the way you figure this out, you multiply whatever is in a permutation by the next, whatever's in the next permutation. So this would be 2x2 is 4. That would be 4 different prompts that would be spawned. So if I submit this, you'll see that it says 4 prompts. And again, you can put like style or stylize in a permutation. You can put weird, levels of weird. You could do chaos, levels of chaos. So for example, I'll show you that. For example, you could do dash dash C, which is the shorthand for chaos. And I could do like, let's say 0, 10, so this would be 2x2 is 4 x 3 is 12. So this should give us 12 different prompts, and I will do the show prompts. Sometimes that works and sometimes it doesn't. It's a little buggy occasionally. So here you see what all the different prompts would be. So this is really neat. It lets you visualize ahead of time what prompts you're going to be getting. So it kind of becomes, in a sense, exponential. Not quite, but it sort of does. And again, you can only do up to 40 prompts. You're going to need those fast hours. So I'm not going to do any of this. We're going to skip over to my notes application. I use Obsidian. So I've done some research ahead of time for things that I think might be really interesting. We're going to do some post photography. And in case you're wondering, post-photography is known as doing photographic images in Midjourney. So the term was coined post-photography, although I'm sure there's probably other contexts for that. But I know post-photography from Midjourney, where you're doing photographic type images, but you're doing it in Midjourney, which I love doing because I've
been a photographer for quite some time. So for me, I love doing photographic images in Midjourney as opposed to like abstract art or a painting or other all kinds of different styles. So this is the style I like. I do many other styles, but for now we will do this. As you can see, I've separated this into some categories like styles, materials, objects, places, atmosphere, time of day. You could do this any way you like. You could put weather. So I thought this would work out well. So essentially we're going to have 3 × 2 = 6, × 3 = 18, and then × 2 = 36. So this will give us 36 prompts. So let's start out. Epic photo. And let's put our first set of curly braces. What gave us 2? So you always, if you're not going to put any words in between the permutations, you probably want to do a space. But you can theoretically, you can do anything you want. I was going to type hello. So you can do really anything in between here that makes sense. But for now, we'll just do colorful Kangxi era porcelain. And then I'm going to do a comma. And I'll do ancient Japanese lacquerware. And I'm going to do cloisonné. And in case you're wondering, cloisonné is an ancient technique for decorating metalwork objects with colored material. So you can get some neat effects with that. So cloisonné. And then we have our next. So we have our objects. So I'm going to do a Hummel figurine. Hummels are these little miniature figurines that typically come from Germany. They're kind of neat, and I think they can give some cool results in Midjourney. And I'll do masquerade mask. That often gives you very nice results. And then I'll do in the Ming Dynasty city of Weizhou. I think that might be kind of fun. So I'm going to skip a space here and do my next set of curly braces, and I'll do a comma, and integrated into the facade of a building in Amsterdam. Wow, that's very specific. But I thought, I've been to Amsterdam a long time ago, over a decade ago, a couple times, and it was really, it's a beautiful city, beautiful country in the Netherlands. So I thought that would be kind of neat with those old canal houses. And then we have in Hirosaki Park. And Hirosaki Park is a very famous Japanese garden in Japan that's known. If you're on Instagram in the spring, you've probably seen like mile after mile of, or not mile after mile, but definitely you've seen tons of cherry trees blossoming. And then we're going to skip space and we're going to do tiny bakelite background. That always gives some interesting effects. And I'll do brilliant colorful twilight. So let's copy and paste this, and I'll go back over to Discord. And here I'm in my permutations demo channel on my Discord server. And let's do imagine, and we'll do this. And for aspect ratio, I don't think, obviously I can't do a permutation with that because I already have, I think we figured out 36 here. So I'll just do --AR 3/2. I think that'll be good. And you always want to make sure you have a space there, otherwise it'll get confused. And let's hit return. And I didn't put a space. How do you like that? So I need a space after the AR. So I'm gonna do --AR 3/2. And we'll just make sure there's enough space there. Yeah, there is. This should work this time. And it says 36 prompts indeed. So that's what we guessed. We have version 6. We have aspect ratio 3/2. And I don't know if it'll, let's see if it'll show the prompts. Yeah, sometimes it chokes on that if you have a lot. But at any rate, we can set the ball in motion. And it's, I'm going to just click yes here, and this will be a lot of fun. Now, I won't show the whole rendering process of this in real time because it'll take a little while, but what I can do is I'll speed it up in post-production, and then you'll kind of get a very interesting sort of time lapse, so to speak, of all these prompts rendering. So I'll be right back. Okay, and we're back, and let's just take a quick look here. So it looks like we got some really nice results. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to blow some of these up and put them in Adobe Lightroom, and then we can take a closer look. Okay, and I've put these images in Adobe Lightroom. Let's take a look. I think we got some really nice stuff here. I'm just going to flip through some of these. You can see the incredible detail that we got. Really nice. So one thing to notice down here, starting with Midjourney 6, they give you some metadata embedded in the image, and that's why I love using Lightroom. So before, what you had to do if you wanted to pull up the image in back in Midjourney, you would copy this hash right here, and then you could do the show command. But now they give you everything in the caption, which is really cool. So you get the prompt, you get the job ID, you get the seed. So let's see. Yeah, no, you don't get the seed, but you get the job ID, you get the full prompt and everything. So that's really cool. I really like that feature a lot. So let's just see here what else we have. Really nice stuff. And I just love some of this bokeh is really nice. It looks like it was, you know, from using, you know, like a Sigma art lens with a Sony Alpha camera. Just really amazing. There's like a Hummel embedded right in the building. That's cool. Some of our masquerade masks in the Japanese garden. Look at the detail on this. One thing that Midjourney 6 has gotten better at, it still needs some improvement, is separating foreground subjects from background subjects. So you can see, for the most part, this little, I guess I would call it a little bear, is pretty much in focus, but we have the blurred background. So yeah, these are just beautiful. I think there's a little kind of surreal effect going on with the mask embedded in the building, and then a mask in the with the cherry blossoms. Just really good stuff. Now, something like this, I'd prefer the little lights to be much smaller. That's probably something I could work on with, you know, maybe specifying like a camera lens aperture, like, you know, something like f1.2 or f1.4, perhaps. But yeah, these are really interesting, and wow, look at that. Just really beautiful. So yeah, really happy that how this came out with Midjourney 6 permutations, and hope you really enjoyed this tutorial, and I hope to be back soon with more. Thank you.